Good afternoon. We are back. We are live. These Urban Times. I'm your host, Terrell Thomas. As usual, every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, we're in the building downtown Atlanta in the Live Hip Hop Daily Studios. And it's beginning to be a bit brisk out here. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas or the holiday season, whatever holiday you celebrate. Much love and respect to you. I know it's currently Hanukkah, so if you do celebrate the Hanukkah season, happy Hanukkah to you. And as we get closer to Christmas, Merry Christmas and Happy Kwanzaa, because all those things are quickly approaching us. And we can tell right here in Atlanta, because it seems like it was 72 days ago, right? And although you may not be able to tell by my attire in the studio, it's probably about 25, 30 degrees outside in the streets of Atlanta right now. But as you know, quite often we're joined at the desk by talented and creative humans out here on Earth doing their thing in the music, entertainment, or sports world. And today we're doing the same. I'm joined by a gentleman who, when you describe the phrase growing up hip-hop, that, you know, we can almost laugh at that. You've done much, much, much more than that. He's a gentleman right now, fresh out of high school, and although you're young in your years of life, you've experienced a whole lot of dope stuff out here on this earth. You go by the name of Westside KJ. How are you today, good brother?
I'm feeling good, man. Thank you for having me.
No, appreciate your time, dog. Appreciate you coming through. Definitely appreciate the peoples and the powers that be that brought you to us as usual. The whole TheoryCon family, we love y'all and appreciate y'all for all y'all do. But it's all about you right now, good sir. It's all about you. You've been dropping music for some time. But as I mentioned, good looking. But as I mentioned, you are I don't want to say a student of hip hop. You're a child of hip hop. You know, you're a child of hip hop. Both your mother and your father have you know what I'm saying, have very prominent roles in the hip hop realm. So talk to me about that. Let us know. Let our viewers know who your mother and father are, and just how it was growing up in a hip hop world like that.
See, my mama mainly, she did like more of the admin work, like paperwork and booking and stuff like that, of that nature, when it comes to people's background with their music.
Mm-hmm.
So like for Def Jam, she had about like 30 projects. So for all 30 different artists and different groups, she's doing all their paperwork, doing all their splits, their W-2s and all that little stuff like that.
Okay.
And then we came down here so she could do it specifically for CTE.
Okay, so she's running with Jeezy.
And then now she's just been branching out, doing her own little thing with different people and different artists and stuff.
Okay.
And my dad, you know, he started with Rockefeller because his brother Biggs owned Rockefeller.
Okay.
But he got his job from Dame, and then he started doing like the A&R work with Jay and them, and then he started, kept going, and he got to really being the A&R, getting comfortable with it, start finding artists and stuff like that. Then later on, now he is who he is.
Now, you being too modest, you know, like in a lot of rap records when I'm from up top. I'm from Philly, and so I grew up in the whole Rockefeller era, growing up loving Rockefeller. Yeah. Hip hop, you know, and even to this day, me and my homies, we have a collective hip hop since 1987. And your father, you know what I'm saying, is hip hop since 1978. Yeah. You know, like, so when you hear Jay-Z and you hear cats talking about hip hop, that's this gentleman's father. When you see Jeezy getting his stuff off and you see different things going on, that's your mother, Miss Erica, and she's a dope woman. She's done dope things for me since I've been out here, helping me grow in the
world.
She does. So that's very dope. So it only makes sense now that you're doing your thing as an artist. Yeah. So before we get into your music, I want to ask you, what was it like growing up in that realm? You growing up in a realm where your mother is helping artists who are significant figures to the hip hop culture, such as the Jay-Z's and the Jeezy's, and your father running, you know, like you say, your uncle was Biggs, you know, you say you growing up in that whole mix as well. What was that like?
I mean, it was like, in New York, it was fun, because I'm from New York, so when I was home, it was more like of a rush, because it was like, that's when stuff was first happening, so like, okay, when the Dipsets was first coming, and the State Properties was first popping off, and stuff like that, and Kanye West first coming about, so it was like, all this stuff, like, around the time, like, the Black Album stuff came out, so like, when all that stuff happened, it's like, I'm a little kid, so it's like, now I'm older, I'm like, oh, I remember that, like, I was there, like, I was like, now it's like, I know all them people, so it's like, when I see them people, it's not like, because I was little, it's not like, I knew, like, oh, this is so-and-so.
How old were you when you say you were, how young were you at that time?
I gotta see what year it was. I probably might have been about like 5, 6.
Okay.
But now I remember like being at the concerts, like, cause I've been to too many Jay-Z concerts to count.
I dig
different
that.
States, all kind of stuff like that. So it's like, when I came down here, it was like the same thing, but it was just like, now I was with Jeezy all the time. So it was like, now it's like, okay, now I'm seeing like what Atlanta got going on and how Atlanta move and how artists in Atlanta are and stuff like that. Cause before it was like, I was used to nothing but Rockefeller and Def Jam. I was raised pretty much in that office, and going upstairs to Rockefeller and being downstairs at Def Jam. So it was like, That's all I knew, pretty much.
How has that influenced your music now? As we mentioned, you're an artist now, and you just recently got graduated high school. Congratulations to you on that. You know, definitely congratulations to you on that. But how has your surroundings or your upbringing influenced your sound and your music?
I think it influenced more like my business mind than it did my music. Cause I think before I was like, I was gonna be a rapper. My pops was like, I always took after my pops, so me and him always talked about like A&R, like activities, mm-hmm. like picking the best songs from albums or just listening to beats, period, or picking out producers like with their specific sounds and stuff. So before I start even thought about rapping, I always like, I'll be A&R. So I always looked at like the full aspect of the project before I even think about rapping on it. So like the whole Kobe and Shaq thing, like we already had it planned all the way out before I even laid a verse about it. Like it just came naturally, like pretty much.
I'm glad you mentioned that because you kind of let me in. So I wanted to talk about that, your two projects. Now first you had Hefe Talk, am I correct? Yeah, that was the first project that you came out with. Why did you decide to go with that theme and that title?
I mean, it really came from my Instagram because I had started like posting my pictures and I don't like writing captions because it don't really make sense. Nobody read it anyway. So I was like, I just start hashtagging stuff. Like if I take a picture with somebody I'm cool with, I put like for life or my brother or like something like that, or like our crew name or something. And then I just start putting Hefe or like Hefe World or something like that. Cause at first that's what it was gonna be called. Okay. Cause like I made like 3 songs in January and that was it. And I ain't do nothing else till like I graduated. So like pretty much we made the whole Hefe Talk like after graduation, like from May.
Okay.
Yeah, like pretty much the whole month of May. And then it was like, when it would start coming time, like close to like getting the mixtape covers and stuff made, it was like, and I had no, and then it really came from, I had a song and I didn't have a name for it. It was just like, I was just rapping. Cause it was like the first song I really made. It was the intro for Hefe Talk. So it was like, when I pretty much was like, when I started calling myself Hefe and everybody started calling me Hefe, it was like, I was like, I'm gonna make it like, that's how I rap. I don't rap, I talk. So it was like Hefe Talk. So I was like, all right, cool. We're gonna call it Hefe Talk. So then the whole mixtape just end up, stuff just like, when I start going with one thing, I start going with it, it's like it just start falling together. Like I said, when I went for the Kobe and Shaq, it just start, songs start coming up like with the themes and the titles and stuff like that. So it's like stuff just start falling together. Now.
So why Kobe and Shaq though? Because I mean, in this era, you might see a lot of cats maybe doing a LeBron and a Wade or a LeBron and Kyrie or Stephen Durant. And you took it back to the classic champs, Kobe and Shaq. So when I saw that, I grew up in that era. And when I graduated high school in the early 2000s or whatnot, that was when Kobe and Shaq was still in their prime. So I was enjoying it late. When I saw your album cover and everything, and I saw the title Kobe and Shaq, I'm like, oh, what is this? This is interesting right here. You know what I'm saying? Like, and when I realized it was a younger cat that had it too, I was even more intrigued. So what was the whole concept? What was the concept for that? Why Kobe and Shaq?
I mean, we looked at it like, we always like just picked after duo names, like me and my friend Miles. I wish he was here with me now, but so we both could expound on it. But we always like picked at duo names when it, like even before I even thought about rapping, because I only been rapping since pretty much like since June, like seriously, like all day every day.
So did you decide to wait till you graduated from school to pursue your career?
It just kind of happened like that, because like when I was in school, I was like, I had went to the studio like one time in January, and that was it. I made like 2 half of songs, and that was it. And then I went one more time in like April, and I made another song with my brother Kid. And after that, it was like I didn't go back. Not like for no reason, nothing. It's just like I just didn't go back.
I dig it.
And then when I graduated, it just like I had free time, and it was like, all right, well, let's put out a mixtape on 629. So like we had a date to make. But pretty much with the Kobe and Shaq thing, it was like after we started like just playing with like the Dre and Snoops and like tag team champions and stuff like that. So we just was like, you know what? We like Kobe and Shaq. Like who don't? And then it's like the way somebody explained it one time, somebody said it, and then I just ran with it. Like I just really put like a whole bunch of effort into like making it, how could I say it? I put a lot of effort into making it attached to us. Like I call it like, okay, like if you look at the picture, he got on the Shaq jersey and I got on the Kobe jersey. Like Kobe kind of led it, but a lot of times it wouldn't be nothing without Shaq.
Mm-hmm.
So on certain songs, you might like the beat more than you like what I'm saying. Or you might like what I'm saying more than you like the beat. So it's like I might carry him, he might carry me, just like Kobe and Shaq. So it's like it all came together like that.
I love how you just described that and broke that down for us. Do you have a favorite track, or if not a favorite track, you know, you may love them all equally, a track that when you were creating and when in the creating process was just it was an experience that was more unique, or you feel like an experience that set aside from the others?
I'll say probably it's two. I'll probably say the last one on there called Ran Up, because that's what started it. And that's what Kid too, my brother, he on that one. That's the only feature on the tape. And then I say that one because when we first did it, I had laid the vocals. I mean, I had laid like that verse on another beat before, but I didn't like the way it sounded. I just kept listening to it over and over again. And then when the Miles had came to the studio, like, he was really thinking about stop making beats. And then he had played one, and I was like, pull that one up. And then he was like, why? And then when I had started rapping it to him, he was like, go in there and say it. And the Kid was sitting right there singing the hook when I walked in there and started laying my verse down.
Okay.
And then he was like, go in there and say that too. So the next thing you know, we had a song. Because he put the hook together, and I had ready to have my verse. So I was like, I'm going to just leave it like that and put it as a snippet. We could put it out whenever. And that's what we did. And then the other song I say is probably Higher Dreams, because we was like, that was like a real random song, but it had ended up being like, I had ended up like just rapping like the whole song, no hook, no nothing, just like just kept going like the same, not really like the same flow, but I just was like, I like this song a lot. I like the way it sounded, and that's kind of one of the songs that a lot of people say they like too, other than I'm the Man. They like that one a lot too.
So what? How do your mom and your dad, what do they feel about you being an artist, and how do they feel about your musical career with them being so heavily involved in the music world? Of course, they seen the good and the bad of the entertainment world. So how do they feel about it, and what has been some of their advice to you?
My mama, she I'm not like, I ain't gonna like embarrass myself or embarrass them. So she not really too worried about like what I'ma say or how I'ma act or what I'ma do. So she really just let me be me, and she just worry about handling my business.
That's love.
You know what I'm saying? So my pops, he's more of the on hand with the music and how stuff sound or how your beats are and stuff like that. So he always mainly like, that's what you like, keep doing that, what you like. Don't really change up what you like or do something for you think they gonna like that. Just keep making what you like. So sooner or later, somebody or a group will pick up to it or something like that. And you have your own fan base or you have your own following and stuff like that.
Do you ever reach out to your uncle? Do you ever reach out to Biz? Like, yeah, hey,
I said, when I make songs, I put them out. I always send them to him. Like, okay. He always, like, when he do his interviews and he do his, like, he's doing the, what is it? He's doing, like, a tour with the shoe they just put out.
I see it. Uh-huh.
So, like, whenever he do interviews and stuff, he always send them to me. Same thing with my dad. I always send him my songs when I drop them, or my mixtapes when I drop them.
That's love. So let me, that's dope that you even mentioned that. Do you get geeked off of that when you see stuff like that? Like, your uncle's been heavily involved in the fashion world in the past 2 years. I mean, I know he was doing it before, but in the past 2 years, he's really taken off with it with November 4th and different things that he's doing now with the revamp of the Rockefeller brand and the partnership with Nike, partnership with Urban Outfitters. So what's like, do you get the free gear, all the cool stuff?
No, when,
or
he,
you like,
when they did the, what's his name, when they first did the, I want to say, I think it was the first collection of the Rock 96 stuff. He showed us.
That's
crazy love with the big box of it. But no, it's tough seeing him like doing all that stuff like that. It's hard. That stuff. Most of the stuff is cool. All the clothes be hard. He got the jean line too. He doing 4th of November.
Mm-hmm.
Then they just put it on hold, but he about to revamp it and bring it back.
Yeah, that's dope. That's when they did a show down here. It was actually your mom and another lady, Miss Watts.
Yeah, they did a in store.
Yeah, that was dope. They gifted us with some hats and shirts.
I think
and
they
stuff
did like
that was
foot
love.
Action, or he
that
got a deal love. With somebody like that.
He making it work, and that's love. That's dope to see how they've transformed. You know, like. Rock Nation,
keeping
the rock alive. That's definitely major. Now, we were also talking off camera about, you know, our mutual love for sports and the NBA and what's taking off right now. Hawks down here, you know, they're revamping, they're doing some things.
But I
understand that you're rocking with a team up in Boston with those Boston Celtics. So you gentlemen have a new revamped roster. Kyrie Irving's on the team now.
Looking good right now.
So talk to me. What's been your thoughts on the NBA season so far, and what's been your thoughts on your Boston Celtics?
I've been watching it from afar, really, this season, but I've been paying attention. There's been a lot of streaks going on.
Mm-hmm.
A couple teams, Cleveland just had one. Celtics had a great one. It's just been a lot of change in the league, I say. With a lot of new places and a lot of new rookies trying to make their name known, and there's been a lot of pressure on them too, I think. Lonzo and stuff like that.
Who's your rookie of the year? You rocking with Jason Tatum and what he's doing for y'all? Ben Simmons is making some noise.
I gotta go with Jason.
You going with Jason Tatum?
Gotta take Jason. He wear green just like everybody else.
Now they saying Gordon Hayward's gonna be walking sooner than later. You know, he's been out of that walking boot, and it's a chance that he's gonna come back.
He could take his time, and you know what I'm saying? We still straight.
Do you think y'all have legitimate championship chances this season?
Yeah. Every season we do.
What's your thoughts on the Kyrie MVP talk? Is he a legitimate contender for MVP the way he's been performing so far this season?
Yeah, he could get it between him and LeBron. LeBron my favorite player, so okay. It's between either him or LeBron gonna take it.
Do you think he's out of here? Do you think he's gonna leave Cleveland and possibly go to? I've heard several things. I've heard he's gonna go to the Lakers. He just LeBron. Recently bought another in the next year. I've heard he might consider the Sixers and playing with Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons. Now I'm hearing things about him going to the Rockets and playing.
I don't know.
With Chris Paul. What do you think that's gonna happen?
You remember when he went to Miami? It was just like random. It just happened. So. Just gotta wait and see, I guess. I don't know.
If you were his agent, if you were one of his homies, you can get his ear. What would you tell him? Would you, if he's like, yo, man, what's up, KJ? Where should I go? Should I stay in Cleveland or should I?
I'd be scared to leave Cleveland again if I was LeBron. See how they acted last time. I don't think they'd be too happy he come back.
He brought him a chip though this time.
I don't think it like. I don't think he. What's his name? I don't think he probably be back. He leave again.
I can dig that.
He probably ain't gonna be too happy with it.
So what else you got coming up in the music realm? Are we gonna see like where do we go next after Kobe and Shaq? What's next? Are you gonna take it back and continue to do classics and?
Yeah, I've been putting people been asking for the Hefe talk too, but I just
okay.
Making songs and like if I like that song a lot, I just be like I think I'm gonna put that on Hefe talk too and just put it to the side. But I just been trying to stay in the studio, just stay working and just keep pumping out as many songs as I can. Just to build my content and just, I don't really put myself in a group or say I have a sound yet. So I always just be like, I just want to keep working to see if I find a sound or if it just stay like whatever I make, it just come out like this. So it, never know how it come out.
Now, do you ever think about, I don't want to say cheating, but cheating, using the cheat codes, you know, you could be like, hey, what's up, Uncle Jay? What's up, Uncle Jeezy? You know, like, hop on this track with me and whatnot. Do you think about that, or are you continuing to just build your sound and build what you?
I look at it like it won't be respected. Like, if I do it myself or if I just, like, amen, if I get to dog. That level or something amen. And then I reach out or it'd be like, we gonna work together, then it'd be cool. But if I'm, like, trying to do it for the, if I do a song with Unc, it'd be like, okay, cool. Nah. I'm out of there. I don't want to do it like that.
I respect that, yo.
I'd rather like get my own 100% buzz and be like, oh, you got a song with your nephew now. Like, oh, that's cool. Now I'd be like, it was hard. Westside KJ and Jeezy got a song together. Him and his nephew did a song. Westside KJ and Jay-Z or something like that.
I respect that, man. I damn sure respect that. What's next for you? What else can we look forward to? The year 2017 is almost up. We know that project is out. Let our audience know where they can check your project out, where they can pick it up, and then let us know what we can look forward to as we get into 2018.
You could get that. You could get Hefe Talk and Kobe and Shaq on all streaming and what's the name? Music outlets, Apple Music, Tidal, Spotify, and so on, Spinrilla, everything like that. And like I said, I just been staying in the studio, but I think I've been reaching out to a couple producers that I'm close with, like Mondo and Mondo, Mario on the beat, and Cardo Got Wings. We thinking about putting some stuff together for some projects.
Shout out Cardo. I know that cat real well. That's
big bro. That's Cardo, he really put together some of the starting steps for me and my music too. He really influenced me to get me and Miles to link up.
Okay.
Because we was already close, but he was like, he's producing. By the time you really start getting on your feet, y'all feel fresh on it, y'all will both be great together. Y'all be shining each other, making each other better. You sharpening him, he sharpening you. So he was like, all right. It made sense. We was already like brothers, so it was like, come on with it.
No, it's no surprise. I mean, you know, they say we was actually having a lot of talk about recently because of the stuff that went online with the cat Keaton and the bullying and all that. And I was saying to cats, you know, it is how you raised and who raised you and the morals they put into you. That's key to life, you know, like, and I mean, it's dope. You know, this is our first time actually meeting.
Yeah.
Of course, you know, I know who your father, I know of your father. I've met your mother on numerous occasions. I know where, but you got your head on straight, good brother. It's dope. I want to see you win out here, man. Very, very, very dope. Like you said, you're 18 years old. Like, and this has been one one of the dopest interviews I've had in a very long time. You know, sitting talking with you, good man. I want you to come back, join us again when you drop your next project, whether it's Hefe Talk 2 or if you do some LeBron and Wade kind of whatever. I want you to come and also bring your man Miles with you as well. You know what I'm saying? So our audience can get to know him as well. One more time, just let our people know where they can follow you via social media.
Everything. You can follow me on everything. Westside_KJ. And if you can't underscore, it's probably a dash.
You know what it is, Terrell Thomas, These Urban Times. We'll be right back. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, Live Hip Hop Daily, and check out Live Hip Hop Daily and These Urban Times for a lot more from Westside KJ, as we'll be presenting and bringing all his new music and a lot more from this brother. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.